What's up, guys? I'm back with more FPL. Got ABR versus Anti, aka Kratos Mana. So we see ABR with Pinsir, Toxapex, Mammoth. One interesting team. And this team looks like some XY or Aura, like more Auras with a Mawile. So that's probably Healing Wish Lari to support Mega Mawile or whatever he wants that gets whittled down to bring it back a light game. Toxapex offense, it was just in call earlier with people and they told me like that you high on the ladder you see offense and then there's a random Toxapex slapped on. So I see 5 offensive ones with Toxapex, but yeah, he has a Bronzong and what could be AV Magnezone. Like, depending on his Toxapex set, if it's more Spadef Toxapex, this Magnezone doesn't have to be Assault Vest, it could be Spags. But I assume the Bronzong is fifth staff, but he's just prepared for stuff like Tapulele with the Magnezone plus Bronzong combination. And he also got the Lady for Choice Scarf later to resist HP fire, even though I wouldn't really switch that in. But I guess you know it's, in case you know it's locked in. So maybe I get the lead matchup. I don't want to say correct, unless he's Chuppleberry. He can probably go into Latios here, and Anti predicts him to go into Latios and goes Hard Heatran. But yeah, Toxapex obviously makes sense. I don't know why he said Latios. Toxapex is one of the best Keldeo switch-ins, I guess, yeah. But he could have went for Calmon there, Anti, if he was the Brandneck Blitz Keldeo set. Maybe the Heatran has off-power. It would be cool to see Z off-power like Tectonic Ridge. So you go for like Magma Storm first to weaken Toxapex, and then you go for Z off-power next turn. That would be a cool lure, I feel. But yeah, it just has Will-O-Wisp, and it ABR gets up a T-Spike, which is, I don't know if that was a good play, because he's T-Wave Latios. Anti has a Gengar to get rid of the T-Spikes, but ABR will probably try to force in the Tangrowth or the Keldeo before Anti gets rid of the T-Spike, so we can poison those. Okay, so Anti got up his rocks on the switch. I assume maybe, what did ABR predict? He's just spamming T-Wave and he's predicting Anti to scout for Earthquake? Or for Surf? Not too sure. Yeah, maybe I brought a team a few weeks ago. He's just spamming T-Wave for some reason. Maybe I brought a team a few weeks ago that was... Why is he spamming T-Wave? So yeah, we see the last move on Heatran is off power. I don't know why he spammed T-Wave with his Latios. He was just trying to bluff Surf or Earthquake the entire time, not sure. So yeah, the Gengar comes in, our Toxapex, doesn't get burned. I could see this being Z-move Gengar, honestly. Like earlier, I was just trying to like, how's that Shadow Ball damage real? 28%, nice chip. As Cursed Body activates again, I feel like Gengar's Cursed Body in SPL activates all the time. Like, no matter what you hit Gengar with, it always activates. I feel like 80% of the time, Cursed Body activates in SPL. That's some Spadef Toxapex. Like earlier I was talking about potential Z off power, but that's just a cool set that I want. Like I wanted that set to do some work or some cool set. I didn't expect it to be that set. So yeah, it's probably, I think if it's not Z move Gengar, yeah, that's Z move Gengar. But that killed? Oh my god, so that was probably a roll to kill, because Shadow Ball only did 28. Let me click data Shadow Ball. How much is base power difference between Shadow Ball and Z Shadow Ball? The power is doubled, so that was a roll to kill. So the Shadow Ball got a min roll earlier and the Z Move got a bit higher roll. Maybe I brought a team what I was trying to save a few minutes ago, or like 2 minutes ago. That was weak, super weak to stuff like Zygarde Zydog. He was facing Zydog that week. Because, like, his ground resist that week was a bronzer. And he brought the team like this again. Because, like, his ground resist at these two basically would levitate. But, I mean, I feel like that's fine in SPL. Because if you predict your opponent to not bring something, to not bring a Zygarde. Even though Anti has an RPG with Zygarde. But I feel like ABR just would predict Anti to bring a specific team that is good versus him. As I assume ABR was maybe Scarf with his Latios and he just sucks off his Mammoth, went to the Marvel that came in after he killed the Gengar with Psychic. Just the way he played that, like, you don't just bring Latios in and risk a Speedtail like that. I feel like otherwise you could have, I guess Magnezone might have died a Focus Blast. I think it might live one Focus Blast from Gengar. Might actually die to Focus Blast, so maybe that was his only play. But I still think he's Scarf Lati. Now he also had, not a Gengar was at full, so Quick Attack from Pinsir was not an option. So the Marowak gets trapped. I don't think Sucker Punch is like 40-ish, 45 to Magnezone. Not too sure about the roll, depends how much bulk the Magnezone has. A Z-move Magnezone. Gigavolt Havoc. Damn, that animation. Marowak just get blown away. I mean, wouldn't Specs T-Wolt have killed the Marowak as well? Like, I don't think that Z-move was needed to outcome Marowak, because Marowak is not the best split dev. I mean, we can see regular Marowak has pretty bad split dev. Mega Marowak has a bit more. Mega Marowak has 55, Omega has 95, so it gets 40 speed def, but the HP is pretty bad. I feel like Specs T-Bot would kill it anyway. But that's definitely the cool set to see though. What would that lure in? I'm trying to think what that would lure in. Because you don't beat a Solvice Tangrowth with that, but which is something that usually switches into Magnezone. What else switches into Magnezone? I guess something like Heatran, kind of. So he can do like a lot of damage to stuff like Heatran. Like, let me just data the base power. T-Bolt. See, T-Bolt is 175 base power. Oh, ABR is still in the lobby chat. He says this game hardly matters. Oh, I think ABR's team cannot make playoffs anymore then. And actually, Anti's team is already in the playoffs. But not sure if ABR's team can still make playoffs, because there's like multiple teams that can still make it. So we can, I was about to say, go to the Keldeo, probably go for a fighting move, but I didn't expect this to be Specs Keldeo. I think that's Specs Keldeo, because Hydro Pump just Oko the Magnezone. Yeah, ABR didn't have good switch ins to that anyway, you just had to hit it. The Pinsir is still looking like a threat, but he cannot bring the Pinsir in because the Keldeo doesn't die to Quick Attack from full, obviously. So like, he has to get some damage on the Keldeo. He also has to get some I don't think ABR can win this actually, because Pinsir gets checked really well by Latios and Latias and Keldeo. Like, I think his only play here is go to Latios. Okay, goes Bronzong. Maybe it's with Death Bronze, I'm not too sure. I feel like Lati was the play there, but like, Lati's probably Scarf, so that doesn't break the Heatran anyways. So we saw Psychic and T-Wave on the Lati, and then probably Dragon Stab. And then it could be Trick or Defog. It has to be Defog because he has a Pinsir. I feel like he has to have Defog with a Pinsir. So that's really, I don't like Scarf Lati as a Defogger. I mean, I get it's offense and it's hard to like fit a defog on offense. Some offense, but also this week doesn't really matter that much, like ABR said. So he has a Pnosis, which is super weird to me. What else would you have on this? Maybe he has Stealth Rock on Mammoth Vine and he has Earthquake Gel while HP is on this, not too sure. But yeah, I guess he just has some heat. As yeah, we see again in the lobby chat that this game doesn't matter to, it's irrelevant to playoffs, as Finch says there. But I think Andy just wins this, like... I feel like he would predict him to go into Pinsir here. But even if he doesn't predict that, like, Andy has 1 month to fodder off, worst case. Like, worst case, he can sack something if the Pinsir comes in and he stays in with the Tangrowth here. Like, even if Pinsir gets an SD up, pretty sure Latios can still revenge it. Draco Meteor, like, it doesn't die to a plus two quick attack. Did I say Latios? I meant Latias. The only way, like, ABR can win this is if he gets multiple SDs with his Pinsir. On, like, a Heatran. Like, if Andy brings in the Paralyzed Heatran on the Pinsir, ABR gets multiple SDs, but I feel like Andy will avoid that scenario. But we shall see. Andy's team looks kinda cool. What was Heatran? What is that for? Let me think about the meta a bit. I mean, it's a nice way to get some chip damage on Toxapex, to like cancel out the Black Sludge at least. He makes the Latios play, but this doesn't... Like, ABR doesn't gain much from this. Like, I feel like he can just go into either Heatran or... If he's a Solvest Tangos, he can just go Tangrowth. So he goes for Defog. And he can just click Rocks again. So, would you go hard on the Pinsir if you are beyond, just hope for Paras and that you can SD up? I don't think that's a good play, but... What else is the way he can win? It's what I'm trying to think about, and I don't really see how he can win. Other than getting SDs up on the Paralyzed Heatran. Yeah, he's just trying to go for that. I think Kelly just Ogre's Pinsir with Specs Pump. But I feel like Scald is a better play here because you don't want to miss. Like, this doesn't matter, and he still wins. Next Scald should bring this in range easily from any hit from Latias, and 1 SD is not enough to kill Latias with quick attack. I don't think you have to go for Hydro Pump, sir. That he thinks he has to go for pump. Like, let's think about this. Like, if he goes for Scald and the Pinsir would live, or he just hits the pump, Bronzong gets blown away. Let me try to think about the scenario. Play slower, people. Maybe I said that was a joke. I mean, I feel like Scalding was fine there, but I'm still trying to think. Like, if Pinsir... Let's say Pinsir goes for SD. Or let's say Pinsir goes for get scalded, lives, doesn't get burned, kills the Kali with frustration. The damage, like after that, he can just bring in the Lali. And then I guess Abby has the Bronzong to switch in, so. And he then kinda has to double into Heatran, or maybe go for Trick if he scarf Lali. Yeah, as he said, you can go Zong and double back. I don't know if I can afford letting Kalia die. I mean, I can get behind where Andy plays this. Cause like afterwards he has a Bronzong to switch in on Ladi. no human has ever hit three. He's going for the dodge, I guess that's his only play. I mean, yeah, I can understand Andy's play. It's if you scald and you let your kill, you die, and then you're kind of forced to go Latios, like I was saying earlier. And then you kind of forced to Draco if the Pinsir went for SD into quick attack on the Keldeo. So that just gives IBR free switch into Bronzong as he hits again, and he just wins this. But yeah, speaking of, like, IBR just gets the free switch into Bronzong after that, so IBR can afford to make an aggressive play then. And like predict Anti to double on the Bronzong into Heatran. Or into Changrove maybe. And if he gets that correct, like, no, I think Anti is just forced to Draco, so Abio can go. Anti would be forced to Draco, as we see Abio go for the probably Scarf Draco on the Kilt. Because if he locks himself into Psychic, he just loses to Ladi, so going for Draco crits was his only play. And yeah, not that Abio had a win con at this point, but yeah, Anti just takes the game. But yeah, I'm still trying to figure out the scenario from earlier. So if Pinsir SDs on the Scald, lives, doesn't get burned, Abio quick attacks the Keldeo, and he's forced into Latios, and then he's forced to Draco in my opinion, so Abio can just go into Bronzong. And the following turn, you can predict Anti to go into Heatran or Tangrowth, can he? I feel like Anti still won the game even if he went for Scald, but I can get behind his play, like trying to avoid the mind games. But it's like, now that I think a bit longer about it, I feel like Scalding would have been fine. Cause looking at what ABR had left, he only had Pinsir, Latios and Bronzong left. Like, he didn't have a good double switch to pressure Anti. Like, if he goes Bronzong, if Bronzong is out, I guess he could double back into Pinsir. Yeah, Pinsir is the best double maybe I could make. If Bronzong is out versus the Ladi, so the Ladi was forced to Draco. And he doubles into Pinsir, predicting him to go into Tangrowth or Heatran, so, and then he could be in a decent position. But yeah, ABR still had to like win a lot of 50-50s or make some godly plays there to come back. So I feel like Scalding was still an okay play, but I'm not too sure. This is really tough. Like, I guess you guys can give your opinion on this in the comments. Thank you guys for watching. I'm trying to upload this now. I don't think there's any more games for today. And then Padlop is playing for OST later on. I will probably not record that, but I'm kind of hyped for that. Thank you guys for watching. It's nice and 3:30 AM. I'm super tired. I'm glad that I was able to catch this live. I'm Doc Rich. I'm signing out. I will see you with way more content upcoming in the next days. Peace out, friends.